a big sago palm that we rescued from a backyard, and we're going to now rescue it. In fact, Luis and Juan have done such a good job of reestablishing this plant that it is now bumping up against the top of the greenhouse, so we're going to have to move it. And you can see not only, Juan, if you can point out the growth on the trunk there, you can see the areas in which Juan and Luis have been successful in growing all these new little sprouts on it. And then now what we're going to do is rescue this, because these big leaves here are just about touching the roof. So I'm going to hand the camera to Hominy, and we're going to go. Juan, how are we going to move this now?
Each one of these will be
like this?
Yeah.
Okay. And then, are you guys going to pull it over and I'll lean this back? Or?
Yeah. Actually, you have to lean.
We both have to.
Yeah. Okay.
I think, you know what we need? Luis's muscles and my weight.
Okay, ready?
Ah! There you go. I don't know if it's my strength or my ballast here. One of the few advantages of being heavy. And what you do with a plant is you always front it out like this so that you don't, so you can keep an eye on, because these are very fragile, these leaves. And of course, one of the benefits of having cycads is that it's scratchy here. And I get to scratch myself on these, the Cephalotus icuriensis. Cycad nurserymen, take note, always. You always want to have long sleeves. Now I think we may have to...
Three or four feet more that it can grow here. Bravo, bravo.
All right.
And that is how we move this big sago. And hopefully, someone will want to buy it. We're going to probably offer it at 50% off its regular price. That's good, guys. You can leave it right there. That's beautiful. That's lovely. Come stand next to it. So now you can see our baby with our fantasy mystery camera woman who's smiling behind the camera, but whose name shall not be mentioned. Anyway, great, thank you.